What's good, Washington fans? Hope everybody's having a good weekend right now. I just wanted to make a quick video about rookie minicamp day two. Of course, a lot of it was really featuring Dyami Brown. If you looked on social media today and the news stations as well, a lot of it was showing Dyami Brown. He looked really good on his routes, really good hands, strong hands. Now, I know we don't want to overreact to rookie minicamp because we've done that in the past with other receivers that have not panned out or have become busts. So I don't think that's going to happen with Dyami. I think Dyami is just too talented. I think he has too much swag, too fast, too much acceleration. Really good. He's a really good route runner. I think he has too much confidence to be a bust. And I think he's going to fit really well with Terry McLaurin and Curtis Samuel, honestly. And the way he makes contested catches and the way he can track the football in the air, like I talked about before, I think he's just too good at that and create separation. I just think he's so talented. This man really is really good at creating separation. I'm excited. He is the rookie that I'm most excited to see, honestly. I know a lot of people want to see Jamin Davis. I do as well. I'm excited for him, but I really want to see that man, Dyami Brown. I know he's going to be our third option, but I think he's going to be a darn good third option. I'm expecting him to have at least 700 yards receiving, or at least I would say 600, 700 yards. If you look at like Jamison Crowder's numbers when he was the third option, that's kind of what he was getting. I know Jamison Crowder also did have a 1,000-yard season, so I'm kind of comparing him to Jamison Crowder in terms of production. That's what I'm looking for his production to be, Jamison Crowder-like or even better than Jamison Crowder, in my opinion. So he looked good. He just looked fast out there. The speed that you saw in the highlights, the speed where he was burning guys downfield consistently, that 4.4 speed, that's what you saw today in drills. Like I said, it's against nobody, no pads on or nothing like that, but try not to get too excited when the guy's showing that acceleration like that and just catching the football, just looking like he's really going to juke a lot of guys out there. So I'm excited for him. Just some quick nuggets. Ron Rivera opened his presser up today praising the other local teams. This is from Ben Stanek. Excited to see the Washington Wizards in the play-in game. Shout out to those Wizards, man. Shout out to Mr. Triple-Double Russell Westbrook. My guy Bradley Beal. They both, in my opinion, should be making the All-NBA team. And they just made the play-in game last night. So Ron Rivera is a big fan of the Washington Wizards. If you look at Scott Turner's Twitter as well, he's a big fan of the Washington Wizards as well. They did talk about, somebody asked him about training camp, where it's going to be. I'm going to try my best to be at training camp this year. They did lift the masks law or whatever it was. People don't have to wear masks. I'm not 100% sure about the rules now about the masks, but they didn't have to wear masks today at the mini camp, so I think in D.C. they're lifting the whole mask mandate and stuff like that. So things are going to be opening up to full capacity. So I'm excited about that. I can't wait to go to training camp. I'm going to be excited. They said it might be in Richmond. So they did train in Richmond last year. I don't know. They don't know where it's going to be yet. But also a little nugget here. Rookies were returning punts. Dax Milne, Derek Forrest, Jarrett Patterson, and Dyami Brown. So keep an eye out for that. We struggled with punt returning last year. We know that was probably one of our biggest weaknesses, Steven Sims fumbling punts. Carolina had a touchdown when Steven Sims muffed the punt. Isaiah Wright muffed a couple punts. I feel like everybody who returned, who was back there, everybody muffed the punt. We just could not find consistent punt returning. I think we had DeCesar Everett return a couple punts, and then we had Danny Johnson return some punts and some kickoffs, and we just struggled. I think Danny Johnson was the most consistent. He didn't drop the football. That's all. We weren't even looking for guys to make moves back. We were just looking for guys just who could just catch the freaking punt. And Steve Sims muffed a punt in the Eagles game that almost cost us in the game, the last game of the year where we won the NFC East Championship. Almost cost. It was crazy. It was ridiculous. But a Derek Forrest has good speed, so that's intriguing. Dax Milne, of course, he's a shifty wide receiver out of BYU. He could definitely do that. Adam Humphries, possibly. Jarrett Patterson, you know, Ron Rivera said he reminds him of Darren Sproles. Jarrett Patterson says he molds his game after Darren Sproles and guys like Maurice Jones-Drew, guys who are like 5'9 and under. Dyami Brown is very shifty as well, so he'd be a darn good punt returner too. So we have some options this year. I'm excited to see what these guys can do. Let's get to Sammys Reyes here. So there's mixed reviews on him. This guy has not played football ever. So this is his first time playing football. Still hasn't even played in the game yet. So this guy's going to be super raw. So a lot of people have been pretty negative about Sammys Reyes in the comment section. If you watch the clips and the videos, if you look at the clips, you can see how raw he is. He's not as fast as people think because remember the 40-yard dash, he was so fast. Everybody's thinking, he's going to be moving so fast like he's Vernon Davis out there or something. But that's not the case. Still learning the game, still learning the nuances, the footwork, how to block, things like that. He does look a little weird and awkward, whatever. But like I said, he has not played a game yet. So it's going to take some time. He's still raw. Pete Horner is a really good tight ends coach. So if he wants to learn under anybody, it's definitely Pete Horner. Pete Horner has helped Logan Thomas develop. So it's going to take some time. Now, Some reporter, I think his name was Michael Phillips, said that he thinks Sammy Reyes is going to be on the practice squad. So if that's the case, then that is very disappointing. You know, we did draft John Bates, so we'll see what he can do. He looks like he's been looking pretty good in practice as well. But Sammy Reyes looks like we have to temper our expectations for him. Now, a lot of people, I know when we signed him, everybody was hyped and excited. I was excited too, but I knew at the same time this guy hasn't played football, so he's not going to come out there and look like Logan Thomas or look like the next coming of Chris Cooley or Vernon Davis or Jordan Reed or anything like that. So what I'm expecting from him is just some good blocking. I'm probably not really expecting more than 10 to 15 catches from Sammy Reyes, to be honest with you. I think he should be better than Jeremy Sprinkle, but right now he's looking really raw. Just, you know, just all the movement you see from him is just has to improve. That's all. He's got to learn the game and get better. It's rookie minicamp, so it's still early. Just like Dyami Brown, I'm not going to get too hyped about him because, you know, it's minicamp. So we can't really make too many conclusions about these guys. Yeah, Sam Cosmi looked darn good. Derek Forrest has looked good, of course. Jared Patterson's looked good. The two DEs that we drafted, they look pretty solid in minicamp as well. Shaka Tony and William Bradley King. The quarterback that has been throwing football is Jordan Tamu. Out of the XFL, he played with the Battlehawks. He was the starter over Taylor Heineke, who was also on the XFL roster for the Battlehawks. I forgot what city they were from, what city the team is from, but Jordan Tamu also went to Ole Miss. He's a dual threat quarterback. He can run. He's pretty quick as well. He fits the mold of what Ron Rivera is looking for with skinny quarterbacks that can run. Taylor Heineke is a skinny quarterback that can run, and Kyle Allen is another skinny, slim quarterback that can run. Ryan Fitzpatrick doesn't really fit that mold, but he is a gunslinger. He does take chances, just like Taylor Heineke does take chances down the field. Kyle Allen takes chances down the field as well. He's not scared to sling the football at all. Ron Rivera said he's really excited to see the Washington's new wide receiver group. Says the team added a lot of speed, and that group could be dynamic. I 100% agree. I think this wide receiver core got a lot better this year, adding Curtis Samuel, Dyami Brown, even Dax Milne, Adam Humphries, of course, as well. They also said Sam Cosmi, his high school coach, said his punch was like getting hit with bricks. And then also another nugget on Jared Patterson. Ron Rivera said, I was just going to mention a specific player, Darren Sproles. I had an opportunity to be with Darren Sproles in San Diego, and that is who this young man reminds me of. He is small, but he is explosive and dynamic. He is stout. So those are basically all of the nuggets that I have today. I'll try to do another one tomorrow, talking about mini camp as well tomorrow. So I'll try to do that. All right, you guys. Stay tuned. So another good day, another dollar, another Wizards win yesterday. Hail to the Wizards and hail to the football team. Peace.